Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creator Process. Today we are back with another text effect design in Adobe Illustrator. We're going to create out these three amazing text effect design using transform option, 3D rotate and extrude and bevel option. The first two designs are totally editable, whereas the third design is non-editable. So you can use this technique and create out your own text effect designs. So let's begin with the designing process. So for the first design, we're going to use the transform tool and the rotate tool. So let's begin. So I'm going to type out text, HOST host, and let's scale up the size with the shift pressed, click and drag and scale up the size. Now, as you can see, our text is in a perspective view where we got little rotation to the text and we got two layers of colors with a depth. So to create that, we're going to use the transform tool, and to give this rotation, we're going to use the rotate tool. So let's first of all give the rotation, but before that, let's add a stroke and a fill color. So I'm going to remove the fill color from here, and we can use the appearance panel to add fill and stroke. So let's open appearance over here, right? And our appearance, add a stroke, new stroke, right? And this will give you a stroke to our text, something like that. And to add a fill color, you can use this and fill it up with some color. Let's say something like that. Now to give a perspective look, we're going to rotate it. So let's select type. Okay, before applying 3D rotate and everything, you have to select the type. If you select other individual layers, it will apply to that layer only. So we have to select the type and go to effect 3D and rotate. Okay, and under rotation, you can adjust the rotation value, something like this. We're gonna give that and set it like that. Okay, so these are three attributes. Using this X, Y, Z, you can adjust the rotation. I think this looks great. If you want to edit more, you can just play around with the value. After that, we're gonna add these depth, right? So we're gonna use transform. So add a new stroke, okay? Add a new stroke, something like this, and we'll place it on the bottom of our fill layer. And to that, we're gonna apply this magenta color. So I'm gonna choose magenta from here, right? And let's apply transform. So go to effect, distort and transform, and choose transform. With the transform tool, you can add these depth using the, by creating number of copies and moving them horizontally or vertically. So we'll adjust the horizontal to 1 and vertical to 1 just to see the difference, and just keep number of copies. So as you can see, it's moving 1 point to the horizontal and 1 point to the vertical, something like this. So if you change the value over here, you can adjust the direction of your copies. So I think this is -1 and this is 2. Okay, so I think this 2 point is fine. So -1 and +2, and after that, let's adjust the number of copies. So let's give 10 is fine, click OK. So we got that magenta. Now we need black color, that is dark color. Okay, so to create that, we're gonna do the same thing. I'll just copy this. So selecting the stroke, click on duplicate selected item, right? And it will create a duplicate. Now selecting the lower layer, right? We're gonna change it to dark blue. And what we'll do is we'll create another copy, few more copies. So we're gonna click on transform. As you have seen, we have already applied transform to this layer, and we have created a copy, right? So it already has the transform option, so we don't need to apply it again. So just click on transform and you got that effect, and just increase the copy. So you wanted 10, we have given 10, so we'll create under 10. So let's add 20. Okay, 10 and 10, and click OK. So here we go, we got that two layers. And lastly, let's change the color. So I'm going to change the fill color to yellow just to give that effect, and adjust the, if you want to adjust the like stroke, you can adjust it, or if you want to adjust the this 3D material, 3D rotator options, you can just go there and play around with the rotation value just to get that look you want. And if you are done with it, just there, and it's finished. And over here, if you see the stars like shapes right over here, I have created that using a polygon. So just to create that, you select the polygon tool over here, left click, and change the size to 8 and click OK. And after that, select these alternate points. So using direct selection tool, right, select these points, this, this, and this, and using the this one, free transform tool, right, free transform tool, just click over here, and with the shift and alt press, click and drag it down, and after that with the direct selection tool just make this corner round, and here it is, and change the color to black. Okay, fill this up with black color and remove the yellow. Okay, so here we go. You can scale it down and create multiple number of duplicates, and that's how we have added this twinkle effect over here. Now let's create this other text, which is a little different from the previous one, a little style. We have got some pattern inside and we have got some depth. If you closely look into this text, you can see there are multiple layers. First one is a stroke, then we got a fill, and after that we got 3-4 more layers in different colors. So we're going to use the transform option to create out this design. So let's begin. Let's type out our text. So click CLUB club, and for this we're going to use the font Avener next bold one, Avener next bold. So here's the text, right? And you can adjust the spacing between the alphabets by going into characters and adjust the spacing around here. So we're going to increase it to around, let's say, 20. Okay, and now let's begin creating this. So first of all, I'll remove the fill color. So go here and remove the fill color, and we'll go to appearance, right? So open appearance. This is the icon for appearance, and you already know you can open it from Windows as well. So going after there, we can just add a stroke, something like that, and increase the stroke thickness, and we'll change the stroke thickness to white color. Okay, and that's how we have given that. Now we need to create this depth, so we'll create that using the transform. So first of all, add a new layer. So I'm going to click on add a new stroke, and we'll place it on the bottom of our fill layer, something like that, or maybe on top here. Okay, and this one we're going to change the color to something maroon color. So we'll go over here, you can choose red, or you can just go in here and tweak the color. So let's tweak the color, something like a little darker. Okay, and we can apply transform. So we'll go to distort and transform option, and here we'll do the same. Let's add one by one and increase the number of copies just to see this like movement, the direction. And what we want is, we want this only, so I'll just reduce the thickness a little bit, this much, that's fine. Click OK, and we can tweak the color. So let's make a little reddish, okay, something like that, and a little bit darker. Okay, yeah, that looks good. Now we'll create few more duplicates of this stroke. So selecting that, click on duplicate, selected item, and this one will place it below our fill color. As you know, we need a fill over here where we need to apply the pattern, and I'll apply it later on. So first of all, we got these two layer on top, white stroke, then we need that dark red stroke, something like that, and after that we need a layer of pattern which will be applied by using the fill color, right? And after that we need a stroke again. So that one is dark black color. So let's apply black. I'll change the color, let's say maybe we'll go over here and choose dark black color, something like this. Okay, and after that let's go to transform and increase the number of copies, something like this. Okay, again we'll create a duplicate. You can just select the stroke and click and drag and create a duplicate. Now selecting the bottom layer, change the color to a little bit red. So double click here and okay, and let's increase the number of copies. Okay, we need to change the color to a little bit more brighter just to see that effect, something like this. Yes, okay. Now we'll create another duplicate of the stroke. So select this stroke, right, and create another duplicate. Select the bottom layer, change the color to bright red. So we'll go to stroke color, make it brighter red color. Okay, and go to transform and number of copies to around this much. Okay, yeah, now you can individually select each of the strokes and tweak the colors as per your requirement. So it depends on you. So example, let's say I want to make it a little bit more red, so I'll just increase it to red tone, and okay, that's how. And lastly, let's add that pattern. So I'll go to the fill color here. As you can see, I have placed the fill color layer on the third layer. So let's select that, and you can apply either a flat color or you can choose a pattern from your design. So let's choose a pattern, So here are some patterns for your design. So like you can choose any of the patterns you want. So I like this pattern, I'll keep it that way. So after applying the pattern, so selecting this, you can go to the fill and you can tweak your patterns from here, right? So choose a nice pattern for your design, and you can even go over here and go to the library, and you can choose different other patterns you can find, like food, garment, natural patterns. In under patterns, you can basic graphics where you get line, dots, and decorative, and lots more. So you can choose, open any of the patterns, and you can apply it in your text, something like this. As you can see, we got lots of pattern you can choose. I think this one is looking good, so I'll keep it that way. And that's how we have created the second text effect. And as I have told you, these texts are easily editable. You can tweak very easily, right? And this one also, you can just type SLIC slice and it will be easily editable. Like, and you can just scale down the size as well if you want. And here we go, we got that nice looking text effect. Now lastly, this one, we're going to use the extrude and bevel option for this. So let's type our text, very simple, alphabet A, and for this I'm going to use the times roman, roman, this one. Okay, so, and let's change the color to white. And here we go, we got that nice text. You can increase the size a little bit, and now let's apply it the effect. So we'll go to effect, 3D and material, and under this, this is the new effects, updated version, updated style, extrude bevel and more. And this is our classic version where we got these effects. So I'm going to use the extrude bevel classic option just to get that feel. Here you got this attributes where you can adjust the rotation of your design, very customizable. I just rotate and place it around here, and let's make a little bit downward, something like this, and a little bit of this angle, and fine, and click OK. And if I want to tweak again, we'll go to here, double click, and let's increase the depth a little bit. So I'm going to increase the extrude depth around, let's say 140, something like that. And now expand it, we'll go to object, expand appearance, and after that ungroup it multiple times, and everything is now separate. We can just delete this, all these unwanted pieces, just to get this effect, right? So selecting that, I have deleted this. Okay, so we are left with this piece. I'm just duplicate this. So with the alt press, click and drag and place it around here and make it align to the back piece. And after that, arrange it to back with the command or control pressed, press open square bracket just to send it back, something like that. And let's change the color. So I'm gonna apply yellow color to this, and this pieces I'm gonna choose white color. So let's choose white color, and here we go, we have created our third text design. Here it is. You can use this technique and apply to any other fonts, any other alphabet you want, and create your own design similar to this. So this is the three text effect design we have created using the transform option, using the 3D rotate and extrude bevel option. I hope you like this video. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to the channel. Thank you.